Top writer for Fox News host Tucker Carlson has resigned from the network after a CNN investigation uncovered his racist and sexist comments on an online message board. CNN's senior media reporter Oliver Darcy broke the story. He joins me now. Good evening, sir. Thank you so much. So tell us what you have learned about this ex-Tucker Carlson lead writer.
Hey, Don. Yeah, Tucker Carlson's top writer, we found, had been posting on a message board under a pseudoname, racist comments, sexist comments, frankly, comments that are too horrific to read on air to you, largely. They use very vulgar language, and it's just shocking to read. I think if viewers go in and check it out on CNN.com, they'll be pretty stunned. But let's zoom back. What we're looking at here is the person that was helping to write the monologues of Tucker Carlson, which are seen by millions of people each night. He has the top-rated show on cable news, the top-rated show actually in cable history the last quarter. The person writing the monologues, helping Tucker Carlson shape those monologues, has been posting for years vulgar, racist, horrific comments on a secret message board. And you know what? We don't know for sure if if this writer had actually written the monologues that the president has shared, but Trump does share a lot of Tucker Carlson's monologues, and according to this writer, he had recently told his Alumni magazine that he writes everything that's in Tucker Carlson's teleprompter.
So I want to read one of the comments. You said some of them were too horrific, but one of the comments that you uncovered in your investigation on a post from this past June, okay, he wrote, "Black dudes staying inside playing Call of Duty is probably one of the biggest factors keeping crime down." That is bad enough, and then it got worse, correct?
It got a lot worse, Don. I mean, frankly, that's a disgusting comment, but if you go and look at the story, you'll see things, again, that we just can't repeat on air. This was behavior that was occurring over the past few years, but also as recently as this week. I think the first example in our story that we cite was from this week. And so, taking together, it paints a picture of this person, again, who's one of the top writers at Fox News. He writes the scripts for the top show on the channel, has been engaged in some pretty disturbing behavior on his spare time under the pseudonym that we uncovered to be him.
Oliver, talk to me about what Fox and NEF are saying about your investigation, because it's not as if they haven't been under fire already for the kinds of things Tucker says on his broadcasts. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, actually, so Fox News only said that this person had resigned. They didn't talk any further about it. They didn't release any other statement. That was all they said. A spokesperson for the network told me earlier today that Tucker Carlson could not be reached for comments. Tucker himself did not directly address this on his program tonight, but he did do a segment about cancel culture and seemed to allude to the story, saying that CNN in particular apparently is a force of cancel culture that's I guess apparently in his eyes not good for society. And like you said, though, Don, Tucker has been in trouble, and he's gotten a hot water over the past few years for some comments. I think we actually have some of these comments where he's called white supremacy a hoax, among other things.
This may be a lot of things, this moment we're living through, but it is definitely not about Black lives. And remember that when they come for you, and at this rate, they will.
If you were to assemble a list, a hierarchy of concerns, of problems this country faces, where would white supremacy be on the list? Right up there with Russia, probably. It's actually not a real problem in America. White supremacy, that's the problem. This is a hoax. Just like the Russia hoax, it's a conspiracy theory.
In the year 2000, Hazleton's population was 2% Hispanic. Just 16 years later, Hazleton is majority Hispanic. That's a lot of change. How would you feel if that happened in your neighborhood?
You know, there are too many comments, Don, like that, if you wanted to actually play that, you'd have to play hours of the comments where Tucker Carlson has ignited controversy for his discussions on race. But those comments look a little different maybe to viewers tonight when they know that the person who wrote the first draft, perhaps, of some of them was an openly posting racist comments, sexist comments on this online message.